On top of the world, you know, inside a lovely place to be, no place to be like Jamaica in this time of year, you know.
That's true. I am so happy you're on the show. We're trying to get you on.
Yeah, well, it's a long time and nothing ever happened before the right time. Now, see, this is indeed the right time.
That's true. Everything happens at the right time. Remember that.
Co-chilling on the works. You know?
So, why did you decide to change your music from doing more like gangster lyrics to more conscious music?
Well, from my early days till I never used to be too fond of gangster stuff, you know? Gangster lyrics is not my kind. I was a man who focused too hard on the lyrics and not niceness and certain principle as a youth, you know? But now I'm becoming a man if I say the world make up on so much different things than just fun and laugh. And you know, what makes it tick, you know?
Right.
What makes things happen, you know?
Right. What made you decide to turn Rasta?
Well, Rasta don't turn Rasta, and Rasta is embedded in us. It's in all the iron and it's just a manifestation to the passage of time.
Is this the right time for you to do it?
Right passage.
Okay, and how has it changed your music?
Musically, it has helped me to make the music more meaningful, you know? Because every time I put the pen to the paper, I have to get the full power out of it because that's where it lies, you know? So it has helped me to become even more in touch with myself. Me, inner me, you know, spiritually. And this work that we're doing here is not only about raving and, you know, you have to be able to receive something from a Buju Banton show, a song or something. You have to receive something, a connection.
Where do you think that your music is going to go ultimately?
Contemporary style.
All right. Well, we're going to play one of my favorite songs on Caribbean Rhythms. All right.
Contemporary.
It was Untold Stories by Buju Banton on Caribbean Rhythms.
People from our boat must see the fusion coming here together in this music, you know, and really get the true essence of it.
What do you think about like all the different people mixing different musics all together, dance all with the hip hop and all the different kind of stuff?
Well, right now is the time for us to come together in whatever way we can, you know. But I mean, as long as you're coming to straight mind, you know, because for years it has always been a one-way street. Like, dancehall being remixed with hip-hop, like hip-hop being remixed with dancehall.
Right, that's true.
You know?
That's true.
So we wanted to be both ways so we all can enjoy it, you know? So I mean, this man wouldn't know what it feel like to be on a dancehall with him. You understand? Likewise, a method man. So it's just unity and coming together. It brings us joy to me.
Right.
It's the BET way, don't you?
That's true. A lot of people very much see you as like the messenger now, the modern day messenger. How do you see yourself?
I see myself when I look in the mirror as the man who Jah put on earth, you know? And whatever I do is life while I'm living it is important, you know? Everybody, whatever you do, the life that you live it is important. So I would advise every single person to make sure that you're doing something at least positive. You know? That's how I see myself in a positive light.
Do you think that dancehall overall is turning more conscious now with people like you and Cableton and different people singing the kind of music that you do?
Well, it has always been conscious, you know, but I mean the revelry and certain vibe of it has been calmed down a little, and the vulgarity of some people class it has been, you know, streamlined a little. Just a little, because if you can have sex, why can't you talk about it? That's how we see this music. You know, that's why after the truth of the art form.
Boy, the dogs love me.
Well, we're on the band, you know. And you know what? When you're on the band, it's just nice to be in Jamaica because it's just livestock, you know.
No matter where you go in Jamaica, you always hear a dog barking, you know?
Enough livestock.
All right, Caribbean Rhythms will be right back with more from Buju Banton in Jamaica.
So don't.
I'm here with the one and only Buju Banton.
Yes. Once more the mix, you know.
That's right. Why do you think that Till Shiloh was such a popular album? And I tell you why I ask this is because people from like all different, you know, ways of life have come up to me and they sing the words and all the words. People who don't even listen to reggae know all the words to it.
Because I, Buju Banton, try my very best to implement a little something for every single person on that album. So everyone can feel like there's something on it for them which they can relate to in some way or the other.
Right. The album had so much international appeal and it really helped you to break through the international market, and you didn't have any like collaborations with major big US stars. You know, and that's really unusual for an album to do that kind of thing without the collaborations. Do you think that or what gave you the confidence to come out with an album like that the way you did? You know what I mean, though?
If Jah stands by my side, why should I be afraid to do what I do best, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I just do that and just leave the rest up to the movie star, you know? When I'm going to the studio to make a project or to complete an album or to do a single, I don't think about reception, I think about making it proper. Because once it's proper, there shall be reception, acceptance. The works just fall, it just fall into place, you know? And although it shall be met with a lot of opposition, but things will fall into place.
Yeah. How do you think that Jamaicans felt about the album, opposed to like foreigners?
Jamaicans, I love it up, you know. Jamaica root until Shiloh was, rooted up and everybody share it up, you know.
You know, swear about when you're in Jamaica and people see big stars and everything, they don't mob them like in the States. They just kind of, you know, have a lot of respect and hail you up. And why is that?
Them say they're not frightened. they are not frightened, you know? So them say, you know?
Yeah.
It's a term we use, you know? You're not frightened.
Right.
So nothing move you, you're not scared, you know? But that is even nice. It makes our day easier.
Right.
To live with natural people.
Yeah. So you can do what you want, go where you want, it's not a problem.
We don't want people to use us as excuse to get crazy.
Right. Do you think that your music is bridging the gap between dancehall and reggae?
Well, there's no gap that needs to be bridged, you know, because you see, I am a young soldier of the dancehall era who knows that my duty is to reggae music. So what am I doing if I'm saying I'm bridging? I'm trying to separate the music. You come, dancehall is the original, is the first, is the stepping stone of the music, and this music is real reggae music. For years, we have been trying to tell the world that there's no two way about it, and they have been trying to say, well, what Bob Marley did and what Peter Tosh did and what we did is two different things. No, it's not. It's to the generation of today, they can relate to us in their manner, and it is still reggae. And the generation of then, they could relate to those man, and it was still reggae, and it was still dancehall. And it still got the same fight, like it's still giving us to be.
Mm-hmm. All right, we'll have to try and stop that perception then. We're going to play one of your older songs, all right? I love this one too. Make My Day, Buju Banton on Caribbean Idols.
Girl, you do.
Successful. But are Caribbean artists rewarded the way they should be with the royalties from the albums and all that kind of stuff?
No. We were never ever treated fairly, and we won't be treated fairly until we start roughing up some of these guys in these big offices, you know? Them take Jamaican artists for fool. Them use us. Them always want to use us in every way, you know? Them use us because them figure we're the cheapest set of acts in the world. Them use us because them figure we're not educated enough to know the business that they are playing and the dirty games that they are playing with us and our music, you know? And in instance, them don't want our music to get big and popular, because if our music get popular, then we'll be in the demand and we will have the final word. And that must never be. But once there's life and once there's Africa, we don't know, we're not holding on to the West, we're going to Africa. So then, you know, it's a better thing. 54 countries to 52 states, a murder.
How do you think it's going to change your culture? I mean, with Caribbean artists getting what is due to them?
Well...
because there's so much talent coming out there, you know?
We need to have our lawyers sitting down on these people's face, you know? You know what I say? And get them to start respecting people and know so well then. Reggae music is also a music that deserves its due. You understand? And far too long, you know, we've been treated just like some loco, you know? And these big super companies come and take our stuff and we're just like another loco commodity, you know? That has been going on for years. That's how these big companies tell life is we the small people. Keep them up there, you know? Yeah, man. No more manipulation, you know? I beg of you.
No, man. Well, you're changing it, so, you know.
Well, with information and programs like these, you know, we hope to make all these people know that we Jamaicans are serious and we will do whatever it takes and whatever is necessary to free ourselves from all necessary bondage.
Okay. All right. Well, we're going to go for a little break right now. When we come back, we'll talk to Buju Banton some more from Kingston, Jamaica.
Be aware.
Hanging out with Buju.
See that? You don't see that.
Buju just finished saying how he has to just stay in Jamaica because he has to wear three shirts in the States. It's true though.
Well, you see, the traffic is just always tropical, you know?
It's true, it's beautiful. So what's the deal with Cell Block now?